This demonstration shows how callouts can help you to quickly trace and manage changes or comments in a document shared between members of a team. As an example, our team of three writes a user guide for a mobile phone. John creates the first version of the document and sends it out for review. Mary, one of the subject matter experts, reviews the document, adds comments, and makes modifications. Tom does a further review of the document and adds more comments. Mary receives the document again and performs another review. At the end, John aggregates all the changes and produces a final version of the document. John, one of the documentation authors, has finished a draft of the setting up an email address topic. He enables the track changes feature to allow oXygen to preserve all changes made by the subject matter experts. Thus, he can later track every change made in the document. Mary, one of the team's subject matter experts, will now review the document draft. She thinks that step 3 of the procedure can be split in two distinct steps. Notice that in its default configuration, oXygen only displays callouts for comments, but in this case, we also want to see callouts for her other changes. To do this, we can go to the Callouts Preferences page. You can reach this Options page either from the application's main menu or directly from an action that is available in the contextual menu of an existing callout. You can choose to have callouts displayed for deletions and insertions, along with the affected content. You can also choose to change the callouts rendering, display the review time and connecting lines, or modify the initial callout width or the maximum number of lines displayed in a callout. However, to quickly adjust the width of the callouts for the current editing session, you can drag the left side of any of the callouts. Back to reviewing. Now, Mary finds that the procedure is missing an important step, so she inserts a new comment. Mary commits the changes, and now Tom, another subject matter expert, will review the document. Tom replies to Mary's comment and suggests an additional step. Tom finds a mistake in the documentation and corrects it. Then he inserts a comment to ask his colleagues to double-check this. Now the document comes back to Mary for further review. Mary checks Tom's comment and confirms the button's name. She replies to Tom, then chooses to mark this discussion thread as being done. Note that this part of the discussion has now been grayed out in order to signal that they are not expecting someone else to add more comments to this thread. Now the review process has ended and the document comes back to John for further editing. John disables the track changes feature because he needs to aggregate all modifications into a final version of the document. Note that if he would have wanted to, John could have printed the document and all the comments will be included in the printed output. Also, oXygen includes a review panel that makes it easy to work with the modifications in a more compact view, and it offers some additional features such as filtering, or being able to accept or reject multiple changes at once. To make more room for the review panel, John decides to hide the callouts. Now, John starts modifying the content based on his colleagues' reviews. He first wants to work with Tom's changes, so he filters them to show all threads that Tom contributed. John addresses Tom's comment at the end of the topic and inserts a new step in the procedure. Now he can remove this thread since he addressed it. Now he wants to see the rest of the changes, so he removes the filter. He decides to accept the rest of the changes. What you've seen so far is the oXygen standard support for handling callouts. If you are a developer, you can use the oXygen API to extend or customize this support to match your particular requirements. And this concludes our demonstration. Thanks for watching.